guys, Just Freckles back online again, and today I'm gonna be doing a desk makeover. Now, you may be able to tell from the noises and where I am that I'm not inside. I'm actually outside in front of my garage because this is gonna not be able to be done inside. I'm gonna be sanding, painting, and putting adhesive on this formica. So let's get started. For this DIY, you're going to really need to think about how you want the finished product to look. I'm going to paint white my wood areas white with chalk paint, and I'm going to be sanding under it because I just want to make sure it has the best possible outcome. So I have some Cork sanding block, a normal plain textured sanding block, and some sanding paper. I don't want to use an electric sander, but if you want to, you can. Make sure if you're like a kid, you need to like make sure you have a parent there to help you. Then I have some paint brushes to paint the wood with the chalk paint, tape measure so I can measure the white bit, which is the formica, so then I don't have the adhesive like wrapped over like half the wood. And then I have some cloths so I can wipe over with some water after I finish sanding. I have some scissors to cut the adhesive. This is what I'm going to be using to smooth out the adhesive, and a Swiss Army knife to basically use as a craft knife. But yeah. Oh, and I almost forgot. Masking tape, and the reason I have my masking tape, I cannot speak today, is so then I can put it around the edges of the formica so then we don't have any white paint going onto the formica. But now, let's start sanding. So now I have two bits of sanding paper. I just took the big yellow square and ripped it in half so then it will easily wrap around the little Cork block. And so basically what I'm gonna do is I'm basically going to wrap it without tape. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start sanding. So it roughly fits the piece. And so I'm gonna try not to take all the varnish off or get to bare wood. I'm just gonna do a very light sand. And quite frankly, I wanna guess how long it takes to do this, and maybe I'll end up timing it to see. But I guess that it'll take about 2 hours. Cause like, doing it with paper, really, it's gonna take a really long time. Now, I'm gonna start sanding. Ah, the desk is upside down. So now we have the desk flipped upside down and we've finished the sanding. It's been about maybe an hour and a half, I'd guess. And now what we're going to do is we're just going to damp a little cloth and then we're going to wipe all the dust particles off the desk. Most of them will probably have blown away in the wind, but we just want to make sure that there are no dust particles because we don't really need to paint the dust particles. So one of the reasons why you're wiping off all the dust particles is because it will make the paint appear better. You don't need to be painting the dust particles because the better the preparation before you paint means the better the outcome will be, the finish, all of those things. It'll come out way, way, way better, and it really makes a huge difference. And it may not seem like it, but like it definitely does. So now I'll spend about 15 minutes wiping this down to make sure there are no dust particles on it, and I'll be back. Whee! So now I've finished wiping it down, I've finished sanding it, and it's actually getting really hot. And so instead of painting it now, we're going to wait until it's later in the day when it's cooler to paint it, because the paint that we're using, it's like it's designed to like dry super fast. And so in the hot sun, it's just gonna make it dry even quicker. And we feel like we've prepared really well, and we're going to wait until later in the day to mask it up and paint it. And we may not even have time to add the adhesive today, but we will definitely be able to do it. So now it's time to do painting. So I have a drop cloth under me, so then no paint will get on the ground, and I'm going to use masking tape to cover the edges of the formica white bit, so that way when we're painting the wood, it won't get onto the formica because we don't need to be painting it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some masking tape. That should be about enough. And just cut it. If I could cut it. Cut it nice and straight. There we go. And then we're just going to put it right close as we can to the wood without getting onto the wood. And I am very much a perfectionist. I like things when they work. And so you'll see me lift up a lot to get absolutely as close as I can. So just like that, and then I'm gonna cover it some more with some more masking tape to finish the edge. And I see that in some like areas when you like mask things, you try and like pull down the masking tape to the length you want it to be. But I don't think you need to do that for this. So I'm trying to get it here nice and close. So there we go. And so that is the first line done. Now I just have to do three more for the top. So we are all masked up, and here is the inside of the desk. We have a few small ear bubbles in the masking tape, but it doesn't really matter if there are ear bubbles. I did get a chance to try what I'm using to smooth out the ear bubbles and the adhesive. So good to know that works, but didn't use it for all of them. So now it's time to start painting. I'm using this amazing, amazing chalk paint. And if you guys have seen my DIY lock art video, I used that paint. So we quickly masked the bottom and flipped it upside down. And now we're gonna start by painting the bottom. I'm really nervous because whenever I start something like painting, I'm like, oh, where do I start? Because there's like so much we need to paint. So I'm just gonna go in. I've already dipped the brush and it's terrifying because now it's like there's no going back. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to drag it so I get the most out of the paint instead of leaving a really thick layer but then having to go in with more, because I can always do a second coat. Okay, and now I'm gonna dip it again. And then I'm gonna scrape one side. So I basically have paint on one half and not the other. And I'm actually gonna go in from the side, start on the side and spread like so. And so I'm gonna keep painting and yeah. I'll tell you guys if I need a second coat, but I think this is pretty good at full coverage. So I think we'll be fine. So I've been painting for a while now, and it's coming along really well. I'm still on the first coat, definitely, but it's coming along really well, and I'm really excited for how it's gonna look now, because it's like the paint's going on, and it's giving me more of a vision of what it's going to look like. And I'm hoping I can get it done today, but we may have to continue this project tomorrow, depending on how the paint treats us. And also dry time, because dry time is really important as well. Okay, well, see you guys in a bit. I've just finished painting most of the bottoms. I didn't paint the tops of the legs, or bottoms of the legs, that's going to be set down on the ground, because A, on 3 of the 4, there are these little stickies, and also you're not really going to be seeing them, so it's not that much of a difference. So I've gone through and painted most of the bottom, and so I'm going to wait a little while, and then we're going to flip it, because I want it to be dry so we're not flipping wet paint. But yeah, so I'm not going to be putting anything on the brown bit, and so that will be the only thing that actually looks the same as it did originally from the whole desk, besides the bottoms. And so that's really cool, I think. So it took about 0.2 seconds to dry, which is terrifying. So we made sure it had an extra like minute to dry, and then we flipped it and cleaned our brushes. So now we're going to start with the inside, and then we're going to do the top bit. But the reason we're starting with the inside is because then the inside can dry and we're not working with wet paint up here and then having to whoop and then go into the inside. So I'm gonna start with the inside now. Okay, let's do that. Also, there's a car alarm going off somewhere. Don't mind it, it's fine. So I've just finished the first coat of paint. I think it looks amazing. I think we've got pretty good coverage in most places, although there are a few places that we could just use a little bit more paint on. So I'm gonna have a second coat soon, maybe even tomorrow, because it's getting kind of late, but yeah, we'll see how it goes. So it's flipped over again, bringing back memories to when I first started painting it. And so now I'm gonna start with the second coat, and I'm gonna start in the same place I'd started with the first coat, just because I'm that person who's like, oh, the memories. Yeah, I know. So this paint is absolutely amazing, and I think it's really good with coverage for wood. And quite frankly, I thought it wouldn't need 2 coats because, like I said before, I've used it in the past. Like, when I did my DIY rock art video, I used this to prep all of my rocks with, and now I'm using it for the whole desk. So I'm definitely gonna be popping some more down here where I needed some, and yeah, I'm just gonna keep going. So we've just finished the second half of the desk, like the top half for the second coat, and it's looking amazing, and I really, really love the chalky finish, like the matte finish. I think it looks absolutely amazing. So tomorrow we are going to peel off the masking tape. We're gonna leave it to dry overnight to make sure it is definitely, dry to the touch, that's it. And then we're gonna peel off the masking tape, and it's gonna look super cool, hopefully, and we'll add on the marble adhesive. Super excited, but it's time to wrap up for today. So it's day 2, and we just did some touch-ups. We just woke up and did some touch-ups because the sun was so bright yesterday that we couldn't see some areas that needed a bit more paint on. So we just went through and did a few touch-ups, and shortly we'll be peeling off the masking tape so then we can add the adhesive. We're using marble adhesive today, but you can use whatever you want. So now it is finally time to peel off the masking tape. been waiting so long to do this. Looking good so far. The trick to peeling off masking tape is to peel it off above instead of pulling outwards. Like if I pulled outwards like that, it would be good because you'd get rips. Boom, so that's one piece done. Is the inside done? Now we're gonna go in here. Oh, why don't we start from this side because that wraps all the way around. Oh, there is yet another piece. Ah, done. Next piece now. And then we're just gonna peel it off. Oh, and we're going around the outside. Oh, never mind, no we aren't. Now it's time to add on the adhesive, and so what we need to do is we have to measure it. So measuring it, it measures to 675, and what we want to do is we want to put 40 millimeters either side to wrap around, and that will add to 755, and then we can measure the adhesive to that, and then we also need to make sure we measure the height to make sure that the adhesive can be cut properly. So a lot of measuring, a lot of maths. Didn't think I would have to do maths on my weekend, but here we are. Now let's measure the adhesive. Okay, so just measured the final length for the height, and it's about 345, so that's what we're going to cut it to. We've got grid lines on the back of the adhesive, so we're using the grid lines to find the right spot to cut. So it's on this side of the ruler, the left side, because I'm left-handed, I need to cut on the left, right down like so. And we also double checked with our measuring tape. We have right here. We locked the right measuring point, and then we're cutting it at the right point. So now it's time to cut it. And this is the part I'm scared about because there's a craft knife. So now it's time to cut. I'm terrified. Oh great. By the way, we did check that this wouldn't ruin the formica, and it doesn't, don't worry. I had an adult start it off for me because I did not want to start it off because it's scary, quite frankly. And so now I'm just pulling down the backing sheet just a little bit at a time and just using a little clip to peel off all of the possible air bubbles as I stick it down. And it's gonna take forever, but how would it not? We're just gonna have to keep peeling. Okay, I'll see you in a century. Getting out some ear bubbles and there we go. I'm so glad that this isn't like rubbing off the lead. So, just finished the adhesive, took a really long time, strangely, and at one point we used a metal ruler, and it put a bit of a mark on the adhesive, but now it's time to pull off this. We used some sewing needles to poke holes in the ear bubbles, like, for example, there's a small, small ear bubble here, and then all you have to do is poke a small hole and then rub over it and it's fine. So, yeah, there are a bunch more ear bubbles that we'll have to get out in a moment. But, yeah, so we have pulled off all the adhesive, and if you lift up the formica, the desk lid, we've wrapped it around just a bit, and so it looks really, really neat now. And so we're going to put another piece to cover the inside top lid, part of the lid, and then we're going to put another piece at the bottom on the like floor bit of the little storage bit. So yeah, have a little while left to still be putting on adhesive, but we'll get through it. Just finished the adhesive completely, almost used an entire like 2 meter lap of the marble adhesive, but couldn't finish everything. So it looks amazing at the top. I think it looks absolutely stunning. And then you lift it up. And then we did the bottom, the base as well. So then up here, we don't talk about that. We ran out of adhesive before we could wrap that. So it's not wrapped right now. But we may go out and get another roll another time and see if we can wrap it later. But for now, let's go inside and style it up for you guys just to get a better feel for the desk. I love this desk so much, and I think it is absolutely amazing. I love the chalky matte finish with the wood, and I think the marble finish is so epic because it adds a bit of elegance into the nice white chalky matte wood. I absolutely love how it turned out, for another reason in that it's way more like, it makes me feel like it's really my desk, you know? Because, like, being able to say, hey, I drew this onto this really cool piece that I did, so it's kind of like mine. It's kind of like that, just, like, having something to definitely be able to say this is mine. And I think it is absolutely amazing. Words cannot express how much I love it. A big thank you to my dad as well, who helped me with the adhesive and sanding and painting. He made the process so much quicker. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and turn on that notification bell to get notified every single time I upload a video. Share this video with all of your friends and all of your family, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye from me, and goodbye from every single one of my freckles.